when we talk about user research, the whole reason we do user research is because we need to understand who is going to use our product.
Yeah.
Right. And one of the examples I like to give is, in Japan, like there's a story of Japan, how coffee was not native to Japan.
Yeah.
Right. Like, so after the World War, when, you know, the international brands like were coming in, they saw that they opened coffee shop, but people were not consuming it because it was not hit. Because at that point of time, people age, they are used to tea. That is their cultural thing. So what these brands did, they launched coffee flavored candies and chocolates.
Yeah.
Which kids started consuming. So they slowly introduced coffee into the diet. And over a period of like 10 years, 15 years, these kids became the coffee lovers.
Penetration. Talk about penetration.
Right. So it's like when you do ethnographic research, this is what you look at. And even in user experience, like user research, we don't look at such a grander level, but we try to understand who it is, where are they using, why are they using. Right. And what kind of product are we going to offer to them? Right. See, if you look at games, right, game is also experience design. And I would say games have always been, you know, the most forward in designing addictive things. Because they make people come back to it. There's nothing like as much people are gaining. There's just a satisfaction. Yeah, nowadays people are making money out of games. That's a different aspect. We have come a long way.
Yeah.
But games have that mechanism. The whole gamification factors make people come back to the product. Right? And that's one thing. Now, how do a company like Cred, if you see, Cred has, you know, crack the code for gamification. Like, I remember when they had launched, it was more of just a credit card payment, right? But they spent quite an amount of time in redefining the whole gamification of the platform. And you will see, like, you know, they have just gone beyond their just a credit card payment. They have like UPI now, they have like rewards, and they have like even you can take like loans from there. Like these micro loans available, that is quick and 30. You need to understand that they understood that there's something that people want. They wanted to be more than a bill payment, specifically credit card bill payment app. See, they didn't go and compete with Google, or they didn't go and compete with, you know, Paytm and all. They said, we will focus on credit card. And because the audience that we use, like people who will use Cred at that point of time is who owns a credit card, or else for others, it's doesn't make sense. Right. Earlier, you could only sign up when you have a credit card, or else there's nothing for you to do on it. But now they have added like their stores and reward function where you earn coins, you spend those coins on, you know, playing some games, and that loop keeps on going. Right. So user research comes into play there. Like I'll give you one example. So this is one of the examples, like one of my mentor, Wendy Johansson. She's a, you know, is a US based founder and a designer. Like she's brilliant. So just before COVID, right? So she started her, they started a product called Me Salud, which is a application to help, you know, the Spanish speaking population connect with Spanish speaking doctors, because we know like during COVID, there was so much chaos, right? And getting people to understand and, you know, on the medication part, that was difficult. And one of the challenges she has, like she has spoken like in her talks also, she has spoken about this, is when they launched, like when they were creating application, they were taking user interviews, and they were taking user interviews on these platforms, like, you know, user testing, all these platforms are available. But after a few interviews, they just realized that, hey, we are talking to people who are already familiar with technology. They know that there's a website like this. they are able to come and sign up and, you know, appear for the interview with AirPods and they have a laptop. They have, like, they are familiar with this. But what about people who don't even know their email or phone number? They just have a phone for communication purpose.
Yeah.
And these are the people who are actually suffering on the ground level.
Yeah.
Who actually need the medication and consultation.
True.
Right? So her team went to local shops, like local marketplaces. They put up a stall and they had like some t-shirts and all this system. They spoke to people. Then they showed them, okay, what is possible? Because these are the people. See, for you and me, signing up a platform is one click. We are so used to it. Okay, connect my Google, connect my Facebook.
Yeah.
The parents don't know.
Yeah.
Right? They are not so familiar with it. So we need to understand. This is where the understanding comes in. We as designer come with a bias and we assume.
Right.
That, okay, my user will do this.
Yeah.
But we have to understand that our assumption might be wrong because that assumption is based on some fact which we have experienced.
True.
Right? Like, when, I don't know, like, I haven't seen a lot of user testing session, but if you see user testing sessions, it's very fun to see because as a designer, you know, oh, I have designed the best thing.
Yeah.
But as a user, they don't care. They are there to perform some task. They need something or they want, they are looking for something. Are they able to achieve it or not? They will click around. If they are not, they will move on.
Yeah.
Right. And this is similar thing that happened in one of my projects that I was leading, that we were working with a fintech. And we were interviewing users. So the thing is, getting users for interviews, one, very difficult. It's not just the early designers who face it.
Yeah.
it's a challenging task, right? And one of the things that we did was difficult was we interviewed people who were like in and around IT industry itself, like someone who is comfortable with, you know, laptop technology, they know. So they could use this app. But then our client said, hey, you know, our target market is on the go, like the shops and all. Why haven't you interviewed them?
Right.
Why are you not talking to them? What is, how do we understand? And that's where, you know, it clicks that why are we not doing it? Because we are also comfortable with certain aspect and getting out of that comfort zone is a very like a push thing.
Right. Yeah.
So user research. Yeah. There are so many techniques, like qualitative gives you the facts. Quantitative just gives you a data. See, it's, yes, it helps you understand that, okay, in Hyderabad, Gachibowli region, I have 1,000 users. Out of those 1,000 users, only 100 users, like 1,000 users who have installed my application. Out of that, only 100 people are using it.
Right.
Right. It's just giving me a number. But I need to understand why are only those 100 people using and why are the 900 other people not using it? There's both the things we need to understand.
Yeah.
Then we can decide, okay, what is the solution? How can we take this 100 people to full 1,000 and how can we grow base audience from 1,000 to 10,000? Right?